Oh, nothing. Okay.
Some statue. Who built it, you think?
I do not know.
Got another story?
One more. There was a tale of a frog. His pond had dried up, so the frog and his son left to find a new home. They found a well. The son saw the water and made to jump in, but the father stopped him. He saw the well was deep, and once inside, they would not be able to escape if the water dried up again. Wisely, they moved on.
That's it?
Yes.
That's really not a story. If the son jumped in, it would be a story.
Then he would be trapped and starve while the father watched helplessly.
See? That's a story. Dock here. Huh?
The water dropped.
And the serpent rose. Right. I knew that. She's really powerful, but you really think the witch can bring a head back to life?
She seems competent in her craft, and we have nothing to lose.
If she can't bring it back to life, can we keep the head?
No, but you may feed it to the fish.
Okay.
Ah!
bet this'll lead out. Decipher those moose barn runes. It also contains the travel room. Should we go visit the fire room? There's got to be a better tool for this job. Turn back, Aesir. Guess the gods aren't welcome here.
Atreus, here!
Yes, Father! I got it! There he is! I hope he remembers us. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie.
Oh!
potential, boy. What does it say?
Yes, sir. Say their neat things upon all who trespass. Father, she is here. It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Hemele! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well... thankfully, his head hasn't decayed much, and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Oh. Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either? Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are god.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
But...
now!
You're welcome!
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Or have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. You better to tell us the way.
The world serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
That's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spit in your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn.
That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. Ooh. You will end me. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why, you...
Travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
Is that one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looks kind of mad for a moment.
Now that, I thought I said you were friends of Odin. No, forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I even see new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries.
That's quite curious.
One more for the collection. So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Here we go!
Nightmares! Ugh! What awful pain! Join him.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Thank you.
Focus up, boy. Well done.
I wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom, Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads? No friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Greedy little dwarf come dragon.
You've never answered the boy's question, Head. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Boy.
This is good to know.
Yeah!
that one, brother.
Strong.
Sir.
Go, you wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. A rather senseless waste of precious life.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand.
You had taken
finish
from this land too early.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones! Gulvig will reward you!
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
Here we go! Maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him. Or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night. So far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. No. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Just give the word. Kasruma! Can't yet!
Chisel.
The
sip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Magically sealed, I'm afraid. Trick, lad.
Thanks. Good idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got distracted.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles. On your mark. Here we go! I'm ready!
Come on.
are brutal. I like crystal base, but where's the crystal?
Read it.
Sir. To Njord, we offer back the seas back.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good arrow.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. So, what can I do for you two? Yes, dear boy. I know you'll use this wisely. What do we miss? If I say so myself. Don't forget to watch.